Hi, I'm Sharon Macklis at IDG Communications, here with Do More with R, interactive tables with one line of code. Tables you can sort and filter can be a good way to explore your data. They're also handy when you want to share a data set, so other people can do some exploring. The R package DT, for data tables, makes creating such tables so easy. Let's take a look. I load two packages, DT and Rio, for importing data. Next, I'll import data about housing prices in 5 U.S. metro areas. This data is based on an index where every city's home price starts at 100 in January of 1995, and then you can see the changes over time. Let's see what that data looks like. First quarter of 1996, Q1 1998, and so on through the first quarter of 2018. There's also a final column showing the change from that 100 starting index through Q1 2018. If you multiply that column by 100, you'll get the percent change. Would you like that in an interactive table? Use DT's data table function. Voila, a table. Let's see what that looks like in a browser. Want to see which area had the highest price in 2010? You can sort by that column. One click sorts ascending, and a second click sorts descending. Would you like to just see San Francisco? Use the search box. And now you just see the San Fran row. There are a lot of other options for data tables. You can add filters with the filter argument. Let's head back to R and take a look. I've got filter equals top here. We'll run that. Now I'll open this table in a browser, and you can see filters for every column. I can filter for all values that are, say, above 250 in 2016. Use the slider, or I can type an exact number in the box here. All rows where Q1 2016 are at least 250. Don't want the row numbers showing up? Here? Use the row names equals false argument. See, I've added that here. I'll run that code. And you can see the row numbers are gone. I can also get rid of this paging menu. A dropdown that shows the first 10 rows doesn't make much sense when all the rows are already showing. I can get rid of that by using the options argument followed by a list and then the paging argument. See the format here in this final line of code. I'll run that. And that menu is gone. So, how do you know what options are available? And which ones are their own arguments to data table, like filter and row names, and which ones have to be in the options equal list argument? That confused me for a while, until I finally broke down and read the help file for the data table function. All the arguments that don't need to be inside options equal list are here, things like row names, call names, caption. For what you can put inside the options list, the help file sends us somewhere else, back to documentation for the data table's JavaScript library. That's because DT is an R wrapper for the data table's JavaScript library. So let's click through. And you can see all available options that we can use. One more useful customization not here is formatting the columns. We can, for example, format the change column so it displays as percents by using DT's format percentage function. It's a separate function, not an option or argument inside data table. Let's head back to R. You can see here that I'm piping the result of the initial table into format percentage. Then that first argument in format percentage is the name of my column, change, and the second one is how many digits I want to round to after the decimal place. I'll run that, open in a browser, and you can see that the change column now displays as percents, but it also sorts properly. There's also a format currency function, which you can use to make a column show dollars and cents, or just add commas to numbers. Let's head back to R. If you type DT colon colon format, you'll see a drop down, or in this case, a drop up menu here, showing a lot of the different format functions available in DT. Would you like to save this table as an HTML file for use elsewhere? You can with the HTML widgets package. I'll load that package, save the table to a variable called my table, and then use the save widget function to save it to an HTML file called mytable.html. Now I can go in Finder, find that, and open it up in a browser without an R session needed. So I can use that on a blog or other website. Pretty cool. That's it for episode 14 of Do More with R. Thanks for watching. Next time, I'll show you how to add a column of inline mini graphs called sparklines to a data table. Meanwhile, for more R tips, head to the More with R video page at go.infoworld.com/morewithr. That's https://go.infoworld.com/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. Or you can add the Do More with R playlist to your YouTube library. So long, and hope to see you next episode for Sparklines.